I'm Al John Go, podcaster and producer of the Disney List, Skull Rock Podcast, and Dining at Disney. When you're creating content, podcasts, webcasting, live streaming, or wanting to step up your video conference calls, you need quality gear and accessories. That's why I use Gator Frameworks in my studio. From professional broadcast boom arms and microphone stands, studio monitor speaker stands, ring light kits, headphone holders, elite furniture studio desks, and acoustic wall treatments, Gator Frameworks has you covered. Gator is the leading brand of cases, stands, and support system solutions for music, pro AV, creative pro, IT, and general utility industries. They have over 1,000 different solutions made from vacuum-form plastics, rational molded plastics, wood, sewn, and EVA materials. Leveraging their expertise in case design and manufacturing, Gator has a complete OEM division that works with leading companies around the world to engineer and create custom cases for original equipment manufacturers. For more information, visit GatorFrameworks.com.
Product provided in exchange for promotional consideration.
I'm Al John Go, co-host of the Disney List podcast, as heard on Sorcerer Radio, as well as Skull Rock podcast, here with my wife, Kristen. Hello.
Hello.
You are an earmarked agent who books Disney travel vacations for people all the time. Give our listeners a reason why they want to give you a call instead of just booking a trip by themselves.
Well, I can do all of the legwork for them. I have expertise. I've been to the Disney parks well over 100 times, so they've got that knowledge at their hand, as well as it saves them time and money.
Where can people get in touch with you so that they can book their next Disney cruise, Disney park trip, Adventures by Disney?
They can contact me at themeparksandcruises@gmail.com.
Você que está ouvindo o seu podcast, sabia que tudo que o Google faz tem a intenção de trazer impacto positivo? Como? O Jefferson da Tributei usou inteligência artificial para facilitar o dia a dia das empresas. Ele e milhares de empreendedores geraram mais de 188 bilhões com as plataformas do Google. E a Miriane se formou em UX com certificados profissionais do Google, criando o seu próprio negócio. Ela e 88% dos formados relataram avanços profissionais como promoção ou novo emprego. Tem que ser bom para todo mundo. Google.
From the Gator Framework Studio in Music City, it's the Dining at Disney podcast.
Another thing about good food, it brings folks together, all walks of life.
You'll discover all the best restaurants and food as you hungrily explore the Disney parks.
Let's do this thing!
The Dining at Disney podcast with your hosts, Kristen Hoetzel, Bubba Alvarez, and Kat Arcori.
Welcome to the Dining at Disney podcast. I am Kristen, and joining me is a cat. Unfortunately, Bubba is out this week, but hopefully he will be back with us next week. If you haven't already, make sure you like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell so you know when we share new content. For those of you new to the show, we do post two shows a week, so definitely make sure you click that subscribe button anywhere that you are getting your podcasts at. Kat, do you want to tell everybody what we're going to be talking about before we get into the little bit of news we have?
Absolutely. Today, we're going to be talking about the 50th anniversary treat updates and the newly announced returning garden rocks for this year's Flower and Garden Festival.
Okay, so our little bit of news story that we have is about the because we mentioned that last time. Oh my gosh. The food and wine festival taking place at Disney's California Adventure. And that will be coming up March 4th through April 26th. We do not have any more details other than that at this time. There are no menus posted yet. But once they do release all of that, we will definitely let you know.
Mm-hmm. And just like Orlando's Food and Wine Festival, there's going to be demonstrations with celebrity chefs, all sorts of stuff. So we'll have more information as that gets closer.
And of course, fun festival merchandise that everybody will want to buy.
Yeah, things with corks on it.
Okay, so we've got some new menu items that have been dropped for the 50th anniversary treats. Do you want to start mentioning some of those, Kat?
Yeah, absolutely. So the Disney Parks Instagram did a fun thing this couple weeks, introducing new items for the 50th that are coming out. The 50th is, of course, a 18-month celebration, so they were always bound to introduce new things. And the first thing that rolled out this week is the 50th anniversary cinnamon roll. It is the giant Mickey-shaped cinnamon roll, and now it has a little 50th anniversary chocolate button on it. It looks super cute. Everybody loves those cinnamon rolls, so can't go wrong with something like that.
We did see where somebody had posted that they're giving away still the old ones without the 50th because they want to get rid of those before they release these.
Well, okay.
So I will say, those of you going, planning to get specific things, just be prepared. Due to current situations, you may not have everything.
Oh, boy.
Kind of like your grocery store. So next is the Slewfoot Sioux Fish Sandwich at Golden Oak Outpost. That looks very interesting. That's a
I like it. It looks cool.
Sandwich.
Yeah, with like a little cabbage slaw on there.
Slaw.
Sure.
Yeah, I like it.
It has the nice shiny bun like McDonald's does with their filet of fish.
Yeah. Yeah, that's what it reminded me of.
Except that looks better than a filet of fish.
Yeah, definitely. Hopefully.
Actually looks like a filet of fish.
An actual filet.
An actual filet.
Yeah.
Or fillet, or fillet, as
what have you.
Yes, exactly.
Next is at the Cheshire Cafe, and it is the Always Tea Time Slush. I had the other new slushes. They were just okay. So hopefully this one is better. But I did hear that Cheshire Cafe, their open dates have been few and far between lately. So
yeah, they've been closed a lot. So
yeah,
good luck trying to find it.
Yeah. It looks interesting though. I like the little 10 over 6. Yeah.
I love it. So cute. So cute. Yeah. Everything there is always like, it looks so cute, but it's just like, okay. The Cheshire cattails are so cute, but they're not great.
They are so cute though. I do agree with that.
Yeah.
They also have over at Gaston's Tavern, you can enjoy a Donald Duck dome cake. So this is super cute, and it looks like something you would see over at Omarette's.
I love those little dome cakes. I don't know if they're any good or not, but they're so cute to look at.
Yes, I agree.
It's doing everything for the gram in my life, honestly. At Pinocchio's Village House, they are having a croque monsieur flatbread. Croque monsieur is ham and cheese, correct?
Yes.
So ham and cheese on a flatbread. Sounds great.
It looks good.
Yeah. So they're also saying that this ham and cheese flatbread is not exactly how it's pictured on there either. So if you look at the Instagram, diced, it'll say that it's got these pieces of ham, but they end up being ham cubes, being served ham cubes. I'm like, that ain't right. You had one job, Disney. You had one job. Take a picture and execute the picture, and they're not doing it.
The food stylists are like earning their money, and nobody else is.
It's like, yeah, you get those ham cubes for the salad bar that we used to use over there. Let's just throw that on top.
Ugh, disappointing.
We also have a new float that you can enjoy over in Aloha Isle. It is the Crooning Flowers Float. So, of course, this is referring to the Enchanted Tiki Room's Singing Flowers.
I want this. It's coconut soft serve in pineapple juice.
Yeah, I think that's going to be good.
Yeah, I'll have 10. It doesn't matter.
I'll also be the bearer of bad news here, but apparently they're serving that drink without the blue feather, and they're putting a little flower in it. A little chocolate flower.
I'm fine with that.
Hey, producer Al John, I just speak the truth here. I'm just, I just report the news, folks.
So let's see. What do we have next, Kat?
The orange and almond tart, also available at Pinocchio's Village House, It's got a little Small World inspired disc on top. I assume that's either chocolate or sugar.
That looks pretty cool. I hope that they serve it with that, because to me, that little decorative disc definitely makes that dessert look really cool and suits it very much for being where you can see it's a small world.
Totally.
Let's see. And next is the Cheers to 50 Years Sunday at Plaza Restaurant. It definitely looks very interesting. Lots and lots of goodies in that.
So this is the one that had the pretzel in it.
Oh, yes.
They've changed it flavor-wise to something else, it looks like. But
yeah, it looks like a brownie. But I will tell you once again, there's you have to be specific when you order it, and you might want to show a picture from the gram, as Kat would say, to the person, because apparently they're still serving it the old way with the pretzel. Just, I hate to be the bearer of bad news.
Hold on.
They had one job.
Keep bringing us down to earth. It's okay.
So, you know, it just, look, they are doing, to their credit, they are doing a lot of great things and sprucing up, refreshing the menu to reflect the 50th anniversary. And not everybody is getting that memo. You know, they get the order comes up on their screen and they're like, okay, we're going to do this. We know how to make it. Bam, bam, bing. And then they send it out and it's like, uh-oh, oopsie.
Not the same.
But here's your little brownie just in case. That's fine. We'll take the brownie and the pretzel.
Yikes. Finally is a Chilling Chamber push pop coming to Sleepy Hollow refreshments.
I've also heard that this is different from the way it's posted as well, which, yeah. Any which way, you're still going to get a nice Haunted Mansion themed push pop.
Yeah, I feel like things like this, you like order it because it's Haunted Mansion themed and like that's the reason.
Oh, yeah.
And it's like cake. So really, as long as it's got the cake in there.
Okay.
Hopefully it has the cake in it. If it's not cake, then I can't help you.
Well, I think that covered all of the new dishes that were released as part of the 50th anniversary. And now we are going to talk about some very exciting news, because things have been different over the past 2 years, the parks, when it comes to what takes place on the American Gardens theater stage. And for those of you that are really big fans of catching bands at that stage, they are returning. So the Garden Rocks concert series is back, guys. I am excited about that, because this is one of my favorite parts about going to the festivals, is getting to see amazing musicians, fun bands, old and new, on stage. So let's go through some of the ones that people will be able to enjoy, because we do have a list.
So many incredible acts are going to be coming to Epcot for this, starting with the Guess Who on March 4th and 5th, Rick Springfield March 6th and 7th, Melina Leon, who is new to the program, March 11th and 12th, Mike Del Guidice, sure, who's currently on tour with Billy Joel, good for him, on March 18th and 19th, Cool and the Gang, who are new to this as well. That's the week I'll be there, so I'm probably going to go see Cool and the Gang. Really excited for that. March 25th through the 28th, the orchestra featuring former members of ELO.
And then for April 1st through the 2nd is the Spinners. The Pointer Sisters are going to be the 3rd and 4th. Blue October, which is new to Garden Rocks, will be on the 8th and 9th. Tommy DiCarlo, the singer for the band Boston, he's new this year, and that'll be on the 15th and 16th, followed by Don Felder, formerly of the Eagles, the 17th and 18th, and then on the 22nd and 23rd, Starship featuring Mickey Thomas. The 24th and 25th is Claudia Lighta, who's new. And then the 29th and 30th is Berlin.
Ooh. May starts out first and second with Toby Mac. The 6th and 7th of May, Blood, Sweat, and Tears. May 8th and 9th, the Commodores, who are new to Garden Rocks. May 13th and 14th, Ambrosia with Peter Beckett, who is also new. May 20th and 21st, A Flock of Seagulls. Get your hairdos out for that one. May 22nd and 23rd, Colin Ray, who's also new. May 27th and 28th, Thelma Houston, also new. And May 29th and 30th, The Little River Band.
June 3rd through the 6th is going to be Simple Plan. The 10th through the 13th is Herman's Hermits, starring Peter Noon. And the 17th through the 20th will be Plain White Tees.
So fun. And starting January 19th, which is next week, you can make reservations to secure your spots with the dining packages, Beer Garden, the Coral Reef Restaurant, the Garden Grill, and Rose and Crown will all have dining packages to secure your VIP seats for these shows.
Very nice. Definitely make sure that you visit freshepcot.com. You'll find all kinds of information there about this festival. And you, of course, you have to follow the hashtag Fresh Epcot because that's what they're going to use.
Definitely.
Use every year.
Who do you guys look forward to seeing on this bill? I mean, I know we're not going to see everybody, people, well, unless you're local, of course, but is there a particular artist other than what you're going to see there, Kat, that you want to check out?
Cool in the Gang. I love Simple Plan. I love Simple Plan. but also, I love Herman's Hermits. Peter Noon is the best DJ on 60s Gold on Sirius XM.
Yes, so. He is. Yes, he is.
Oh, gosh.
How about you, Kristen?
Oh, I think I'd have to go with Berlin.
Oh, Berlin?
Yeah. Nice. Yeah, I think Berlin.
Berlin, take my breath away, right?
Yep.
Yep. Metro. They got a few hits.
Yeah.
I know their guitarist. He's good.
The Pointer Sisters. Don't they play the Neutron Dance somewhere?
That's right.
I'm in.
That's right. They used to do the Neutron Dance as part of that 80s Disney what was it that 80s Disney record with a Material Girl, the Minnie Mouse? I'm trying to remember. I think it was New
Jersey. Suzanne Summers, Totally Mickey.
Minnie? Yeah, Totally Mickey. Totally Minnie. Yeah, yeah, Totally Minnie, right? Yeah. Maybe I'm wrong.
You're totally right.
I have
that on vinyl.
Okay, don't give me hate mail, but.
No, it's right.
Nice.
Well, I don't know anybody else, but I'm ready for all of these festivals. Now that we've talked about everything, I'm just like, I want to be there like now.
I want to hear, I'm excited to hear, first of all, what kitchens are coming back for that. And then also what the topiaries, the special topiaries are going to be this year. Because last year it was like a camping thing. It's kind of weird. So hopefully something interesting this year.
Maybe they'll have a Seeing Red theme, you know, for that Pixar movie.
Oh, yeah. That'd be cute. Because red pandas. Got animals
and pandas and stuff in it. So maybe they'll do that. You know?
That'd be so cute.
That would be. Everybody needs to see it on Disney Plus. So.
Yeah. Well, they'll have to start telling us soon because March isn't too far away.
Don't say that. I'm going to be so old.
Oh, come on.
We're still older than you, Kat.
Come on.
No. I'm a grandma. Nobody's older than me.
Oh, gosh. We hope you enjoyed today's show. If you haven't already, make sure you like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell. You can find us on Anchor or any of the other amazing podcasting platforms out there. For those of you that would like to support the show, you can do that a few ways. One, of course, is all those likes. That's a free way to do it. You can also shop our links like Amazon, Disney Store, and Garden Grocer that you can find on diningatdisney.com. Or for as little as 99 cents a month or as much as $9.99 a month, you can support us by sponsoring the podcast on Anchor. Kat, do you want to tell everybody where they can find you?
Yes. You can find me on Instagram at catastrophe, at CAT_ASTROPHE. As far as Dining at Disney, you can check out diningatdisney.com and follow us on our social media accounts on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube. And for all your Disney, Universal, and cruise travel, you can contact Kristen at themeparksandcruises@gmail.com for your free quote and to book. Make sure to check out some other great podcasts, including The Disney List with Kristen and Al John, WDW Park Hoppers with Park Hopper John and Park Hopper Sid, Disney Parks Podcast with Tony and John, Skull Rock Podcast with Al John and Dave Bossert, and my podcast, Eat the Picture. For Facebook fun, join our friends, the Disney Dorks and the Sorcerer Radio Fun Zone.
Until next time, I'm Kristen, and with me was Kat. Bon appetit.
Information and opinions expressed in this podcast are for entertainment and informational purposes. All other trademarks mentioned are the property of their respective owners.
I'm Kristen Hoetzel, vacation planner, world traveler, Disney foodie, and theme park fan.
I'm Al John Go. I'm the husband who's also Disney, Star Wars, and Marvel Comics fan. And together, we host a Disney List podcast.
Every week, you'll hear us list our favorite things about Disney theme parks, films, shows, travel, Marvel, and Star Wars in a top 10 list, rankings, and more.
That's an impressive list. Subscribe to the Disney List podcast on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, iHeartRadio, or your favorite podcast platform. You can even stream us on Sorcerer Radio at srsounds.com and check out our live shows on Facebook. The Disney List podcast. Visit thedisneylist.com.
Eat the Pictures is a bite-sized movie podcast. Every week, we look at the ways different movies, from classic horror to rom-com, use food to tell stories on screen. Food unites us all. Let's explore it piece by piece on Eat the Pictures. Stay hungry.
Skull Rock Podcast, talking all things Disney, with your hosts, Al John Go and Dave Bossert.
Do you just love to learn more about the magic that embodies animated films, theme park attractions, and more? The all-encompassing universe created and produced by the genius of Walt Disney has spanned nearly 100 years and counting.
From his earliest film endeavors with the Laugh-O-Gram cartoons and the Alice comedies, to the creation of Mickey Mouse, to the first animated feature film, Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs, and then dreaming of Disneyland, Walt Disney continuously raised the creative bar, and today his company has carried on that tradition as a global entertainment juggernaut. I'm Dave Bossert, artist, filmmaker, and author.
And I'm Al John Go, musician, podcaster, and radio guy. Every week, Dave and I will explore the entertainment galaxy that is Disney with insightful conversation, stories, and special guests talking all things Disney.
Listen to never-before-heard stories and behind-the-scenes moments from some of your favorite Disney films, theme park attractions, performances, books, music, and so much more from knowledgeable, insightful, and thought-provoking hosts and guests. Hear the latest news about Disney past, present, and future.
Skull Rock Podcast is your go-to source for the magic we all love. Skull Rock Podcast, coming soon. Visit skullrockpodcast.com.